Hello everyone, in today's video, I'll be teaching you how to create a walking NPC system inside your game using two different methods, the looped method and the respawn-despawn method. Make sure to subscribe and leave a like on the video. Start off by importing your character into the game. This one's called NPC, I'm going to leave it as NPC. Now you can do this many ways, like through the toolbox and other plugins. Alright, once you have your character inside the game, we can actually go into the workplace and insert a folder into the workplace. I'm going to rename this folder to NPC nodes. Just like that. Now, once we have our NPC nodes, what we're actually going to do is insert a part into the game, scale it down to a decent size. I'm going to do a 1x1 cube, and we're going to just duplicate it and move it in order for the path we want the NPC to travel. I'm going to quickly get this done. Alright, just like that, I have all the parts in an order around this monument over here. And now I'm going to select all these parts and insert, put them inside the nodes folder. Now you're going to start from part number one and start renaming them so that it starts from the first part and then it'll travel to the second part. Which, as you can see, the order is kind of messed up here. Now keep in mind that they're not actually ordered if you have more than 10. So if you have more than 10, what you're going to want to do is put a 0 in front of all your numbers. And once it's done, you're going to repaste them inside the folder. Once they're all ordered with a 0 in front of them, if you have more than 10, if you have more than 100, you're going to want 2 zeros in front of them. So simply Control X and then Control Shift V inside there. Now as you can see, it'll start going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And as the code will run through it, it'll go down each one numerically. Alright, so let's start creating the code. To make everything simpler, I'm actually going to insert the script inside of our NPC nodes. I'm just going to rename this to looped NPC, as this NPC is going to have a looped animated scheme, or however you want to call it. Alright, so let's start off with local NPC. It's going to be equal to workplace dot what's our name, just NPC. If you have more, I recommend giving like this one NPC1, NPC2, to make it easier for your code to find it. Anyways, our next variable is going to be our nodes folder, which is going to be equal to script.parent. Alright, now we're going to go local looped is just equal to true. It's not a other one. And then we're going to repeat this. So for I and every node in pairs, nodes folder, and then we're going to get all the children inside of it. And for every children, we're going to do if the node is a, and what we're going to do, and we're going to check if it's a part, because we don't want to accidentally get this script, or if for some reason we have a remote event in here, we don't want it to accidentally count this remote event and completely break our loop. All right, so if it's a part, then what we're going to do is we're going to repeat it on all this. So npc.humanoid colon move to node and then dot position, and then we're going to wait, and then we're going to repeat this until npc dot humanoid dot move to finished colon wait. So it's gonna do this until it has moved to this node position. It's gonna keep repeating it until it is there, because if we don't have this repeat and we just have this and then we have our wait, or if we just have this line of code then this line of code, what's gonna happen is it'll automatically time out after 8 seconds and not reach its destination, and then it'll just stop. So we're just gonna have this repeat until it has got to that position, and then we're gonna do this until looped is equal to false, which it will never be, so just keep doing it. So that's our looped NPC code. Now I'll show you how to make our respawn despawn system. Let's create the respawn despawn system now. So let's insert our character, and we're going to create nodes just like we did with our other one, very end, just like that. This node is an axe to be used. It's just going to be to make sure that it teleports back to its first positions flawlessly. All right, now that we have all our nodes in place, what we're going to do is we're going to insert a script. We can call this one spawn despawn script. And then essentially what we can do is we can actually just completely copy this one and paste it into here. Now all we're going to do is we're going to go with a local NPC position, which is going to end up being equal to our NPC dot humanoid root part dot C frame. All right. And then we can actually copy this little line of code over here. And then we'll go down to the bottom, we'll paste this in, and we'll equal that to the NPC position. So once this is done, it will go back to here. Alright, now let's test out and see how these work. Now if you're getting any errors during testing, that's probably because you forgot to anchor these. As you can see, our NPC nicely pathfinds along the nodes that we placed. Now as you can see, they don't have much of a walking animation. In this next part of the tutorial, I'm going to teach you just how to make the walking animation. And if you're having problems right now with timing out errors, you probably forgot to anchor your nodes. Make sure those are anchored. Let's make a walking animation. To do this, click on our NPC, and we're going to expand it, and we're going to expand our humanoid. Inside of here, we're going to actually add in a script, and we can call this script walk. Alright, and we'll close out that script for now, and inside of this walk, we're actually going to add in an animation. And we can call this, I'll just leave it as animation. So now, we're going to click on our animation in here. I have an animation ID. I'll leave this in the description below so you can use this animation ID. Alright, let's get into coding. Let's start coding our animation. So let's start off with getting our animation, which is going to be local animation. Animation is equal to script, and then we're going to wait for the child as the script is going to load in before the walk animation. So animation. And then we can do is we can go local humanoid, which is going to be our humanoid. And we'll get script.parent, as that is our humanoid. And then lastly, we're just going to get our animation, which I'll call walking. Alright, so walking is going to be equal to humanoid, colon, and then we're just going to load the animation, which is called animation. So walk, walking, colon, play, and we'll do walking equals looped, or walking.looped is equal to true. Alright. And now we can close out that, and if we run the game, you'll see that our character will have a walking animation. As you can see, our previously very stale character now has its nice walking animation. We have one last problem that we need to solve, and that is making sure that our NPCs won't interact with our player, as that can mess them up a lot. We also want to make sure that they don't interact with each other, as them colliding with each other will also mess a lot of things up. So, I'll teach you just how to do that. Start off by going into your model tab, and we're going to go into our collision groups. We're going to add a group, call our first one NPC, and add one more, which is going to be called player. Inside our NPC group, we're going to make sure that our NPCs cannot interact with our player, nor can they interact with themselves. And that should automatically make sure that our player cannot interact with an NPC. Alright, we can now close out this, and inside a server script service, we'll add in a script. We'll call this player collide, or player collision manager. I'll give it a fancy name like that. It doesn't have to be fancy, but essentially we're going to do game.players.playerAdded, and then we're going to quickly create a function over here, and we'll title the player that just joined to be player. Alright, so local character is going to be equal to player.character or player.characterAdded colon wait. Now basically I always use both of these because sometimes one will work and the other one will work. So this is basically the safest way to get both of them no matter what happens. Alright, now for I in part in pairs, and then we're going to go with the character, and then we're going to go get all its descendants. Essentially what a descendant is that if there's a part inside of a part, it'll get that part inside that part inside that part, and it'll keep going and it'll get everything basically. And it's just going to do this, and then we're going to check if the part, or if part colon is a, well, a part, or the part colon is a mesh part, then what we're going to get it to do is we're going to go with part dot collision group is going to be equal to, or actually, no, it should be like that, player. Now what we can do is we can close out of this, and inside of this NPC, we have one last thing to do, and that's inside of all of its parts. Just like this, and then where's its collision group? As you can see, this one's already set to NPC by default because this one was taken from the one I made before. Now I'm demonstrating how to make it. Alright, so now we can actually replay this in game, and we'll see if we can collide with it. As you can see, our character cannot collide with NPC. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you soon in another one of my Roblox Studio tutorials. Goodbye.